Please pause for a moment of quiet reflection.
Please stand for the Pledge of Allegiance.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
We are the Alpharetta High School, and your morning show starts right now.
Good morning, Alpharetta. I'm Van Emberger.
And I'm Maya Thurman, and welcome back to this week's morning show.
It's senior night on Thursday, September 26th for your Alpharetta Volleyball Raiders. Seniors getting free with your AHS badge. Come and support your 8 senior players as they battle out against Blessed Trinity at 5 and Walker at 7 with a special senior ceremony prior to the 7 p.m. match.
Seniors, the link to vote for your homecoming king and queen is open now. Go to www.tinyurl.com/seniorhookahvote2019 by this Thursday, 9/26, to cast your vote. Only seniors may vote once. Good luck to the finalists.
Our home football games are being streamed on YouTube on our channel AHS Video. Please subscribe to our channel and click on notifications so you get timely updates.
Each day, each class and club that has the entire class or club dressed up for the day with photo evidence submitted by the teacher or club sponsor to Ms. Vizeau by 3:30 p.m. will be entered into a drawing for fun prizes from Dr. Kersey, such as a class or club donut party, pizza party, Rich Raider tickets, spirit wear tickets to the homecoming football game, and perhaps a pair of tickets to the homecoming dance.
Latino Mentorship Club will have their meeting on Wednesday, September 25th in the Media Center during lunch A and B. All male Latino students are welcome. Please come to Ms. Pop Room 1320 to confirm your participation. Pizza will be provided.
Help save lives. Donate blood at SNHS's semi-annual Red Cross Blood Drive. The blood drive will be held October 1st from 9 a.m. to 3 p.m. Please scan the QR code or visit tinyurl.com/blooddonor19 to donate.
Hi, my name is Leahy Freeman. I'm here at Fire Station 83 in Alpharetta, Georgia. I got the amazing opportunity to sit down and talk to firefighter Adele Hart about her journey. Take a look.
I am a firefighter and EMT for the city of Alpharetta. Our primary responsibility is to respond to fires, accidents, and any calls where people need us 24/7.
Hart is originally from South Africa. When she moved to America as an au pair, she felt as if something was missing in her life. There was no excitement, adrenaline rushes, or anything to make her look forward to going to work. She lived behind the fire station that she drove past every day. Hart had a feeling that she had to go in there and find out how she could become a firefighter.
You're not just gonna get it on a plate. You have to actually work for this. You have to work hard and put in the work, make people see that you wanna do this job, and you will earn their respect. Try your best and you will succeed. At the end, you will succeed. People will notice how hard you work and you will succeed.
Hart proved that hard work does pay off, and it is important to follow your passion and never give up, even in the hard times. I also asked her how she knew that this was what she was meant to do. This is what she had to say.
For a really long time, I didn't know what I wanted to do, and I didn't feel like I had a purpose in life. And I tried a lot of things, and everything I tried, I just didn't feel happy with what I was doing and accomplished. And one day I just walked into the fire station because I saw fire trucks all the time coming from a different country, and I came to America and I saw the fire trucks, and it was just like, wow.
Lastly, this quote by Colin Powell says, "Always remember, a dream doesn't become reality through magic. It takes sweat, determination, and hard work." Thank you for your service. I'm Leahy Freeman for The Morning Show.
And now let's check in with Amanda with the weather.
Good morning, Alpharetta. I'm Amanda Kinneman with this week's weather. Today, you will see a high of 88 and a low of 64. Summer still hasn't left. Thursday will be sunny with a high of 92 and a low of 67. Friday will be mostly sunny with a high of 93 and a low of 67. This week will be mostly sunny with the highs of 92 and lows of 66. Have a great week, Alpharetta.
There were many environmental protests around the world this week. To catch you up on what happened, I'm Max Smith. From Paris to Peshawar, Washington State to Washington, D.C., hundreds of thousands of young people led protests on Friday, demanding action on climate change as the United Nations summit happened on Monday. The global climate strike protests have been inspired by Greta Thunberg, a 16-year-old Swedish activist who met with members of Congress, urging them to heed scientists' warning. As protesters gathered in New York on Friday to hear Thunberg speak, she tweeted that Battery Park had overflowed with more than 250,000 people. Rallies were intended to be peaceful, but next week, U.S. activists plan to start more confrontational protests amid to startle Washington traffic and disrupt San Francisco's financial district. D.C. police said they arrested 26 protesters across the city for blocking traffic, while U.S. Capitol Police arrested 6 others near the Capitol, a building. Authorities noted 15 locations that were blocked at various times, forcing motorists to navigate blockades at some of the city's busiest intersections as the work week began. There were some concrete measures after the United Nations summit on Monday. The United Nations Secretary General, Antonio Guterres, said in the closing remarks that 77 countries had announced efforts to achieve net zero emissions by 2050. I'm Max Smith for The Morning Show.
Have you ever been stressed from school? Have you ever been given an excessive amount of homework with no time at all? Well, imagine if that all disappeared. Finland possibly has one of the greatest school systems to this day, with a high school graduation rate of 99%, while the United States has a graduation rate of 84.6%. And fun fact, they give out substantially less homework than other countries like the United States. While homework may improve grades by providing a homework grade within the gradebook, most students don't retain the actual information from their homework because students simply do not have time to complete all their work.
It definitely has an influence. Like, if you get 100s on all of them, it's definitely going to improve your grade a little bit by a couple of points.
I don't necessarily learn more from the homework that I'm given, but it definitely somewhat reinforces the material.
As a result, some students may cheat on their work just to get a good grade within the grade book.
I know plenty of people who go online and search for the answers just because it's the easy way out, and it's the way to get it done without having to put in work.
Like, you have to go to multiple websites and try to find the information.
End up turning to Google because it's like their last resort, because they can't get a hold of their teacher at 1 in the morning when they get home from work.
Students believe if they had more one-on-one time with teachers, understanding concepts would be a breeze.
I think if teachers specifically hammered in on certain concepts and let us review over and over and over again in class, then there's no need to practice after school.
Yeah, it's definitely helpful to have someone there in person, because then if you get stuck, you don't have to go through pages and pages of Google finding stuff.
While no country has the perfect school system, this is definitely a sign to take a step in the right direction. Our goal is to keep stress down and have students truly learn what is taught inside the classroom. My name is Vandenberger with The Morning Show.
All right, hey, I'm Jordan. We back with Funny Questions. Hey, what's your name?
Alex.
Justice.
Janae.
Poncho.
Gianna.
Francesca.
What's 13 minus 50?
T minus 50.
70.
I know.
Negative 27.
Yep, you right. Yes. You wrong.
Negative 46.
Negative 37.
Negative 37.
How many feet are in an inch?
There's no feet in an inch.
How many feet are in an inch?
12.
12 inches.
Good morning, Alpharetta. I'm Harrison Michaels, and with me today is Kai Rico, Noah Lynch, and Carson Melton. We are your Rowdy Raiders.
We want to fill you in on the homecoming pep rally that is being held on Friday, September 27th in the Alpharetta Gym.
Remember, pep rallies are a time to show off our school spirit, especially at the homecoming pep rally. Get ready for the Friday night's football game.
We all know the pep rallies here have not always been in high spirit, but we want to change that, so listen up. Previously, our student council went to Northview and Johns Creek High School and experienced a very fun pep rally. To them, they were having too much fun, and that's because we are not having enough fun. Time to make this fun, boys and girls. We're going to have a pep rally on Friday, September 27th, and bring your rowdiness and school spirit with you. The moment you walk in, get hype. We're not having too much fun, so get hype.
Remember, that Friday, the 27th, is Work It Out 80s Day for School Spirit Week. So as you plan out what you want to wear, keep in mind, we want all the freshmen to wear pink, all the sophomores to wear yellow, all the juniors to wear green, and all the seniors to wear blue.
We really want to make this year the best year ever, and we need your help. We are all part of Raider Nation.
One more thing before we are done. Each class will have a class chant. We want you to be able to use these to let us know your entire class is represented at the pep rally. All we want you to do is yell at the top of your lungs, Raiders, and then your class. So since us four are seniors, we would say Raiders.
Raiders, seniors!
Yeah, what he said.
To help you get hype, we, as your fellow rowdy Raiders, will do a separate chant, and we want you guys to join in. So listen at the pep rally and just be ready to yell. We need everyone there, and see you all at the pep rally.
Thanks for checking in. I'm Maya.
And I'm Van, and you've been watching The Morning Show.